Good evening, everyone. I'm Craig.
And I'm Mel.
And you're with Lovin' DisWorld. And tonight we have dining reservations at Tony's here on Main Street at the iconic Magic Kingdom. I can't wait to get inside. How about you?
I'm excited. We haven't been here for a couple of years, so I'm ready to give it a try again.
Yeah, it has been a while since we've been here, so we can't wait to see how the menus change, see about the food, take you inside for the ride. So come on in and let's enjoy a great dinner. So we just got seated here at Tony's. I think the one big drawing factor to this restaurant is that it's in the Magic Kingdom. There's not a whole lot of sit-down places inside the Magic Kingdom that are affordable family options. You know, you do have Cinderella's Castle, you have Be Our Guest, but they're a little higher on the price point than what Tony's is. I'll say it's a very nice looking restaurant. It has the Lady and the Tramp theme, which is really nice because Lady and the Tramp really doesn't get too much love from Disney. So to have a restaurant with that exact theming is great. They have artwork from the movie throughout the restaurant. In the middle, they have a Lady and the Tramp statue with a nice little water fountain around it. So it is. It's a very nice looking restaurant. Fortunately, it is a little loud, but that's all right. We're really excited to get our food. We started with the mozzarella sticks as an appetizer. I got the chicken parmesan. Melissa got the chicken fettuccine alfredo. For Connor, we got grilled chicken. The sides are a little suspect, especially for a pasta place. But other than that, we can't wait to try our food, and it's going to be fantastic. So there is our appetizer, which we got the fried mozzarella. Don't know if the value's all there for that. Basically $12 for six.
Oh, we got seven.
Oh, we got seven fried bowls of mozzarella. We'll try them and see what they're like though. In addition, at the same time as our appetizer, we received that bread which looks like some kind of an oil-based dip. We'll have to give that a try and see what that's like as well.
It's a different kind of bread. It kind of disintegrates in your mouth. I don't know. But it's good. Not like, woo, bread. But, oh, I got something really hot. Woo! I don't know what's in there.
I think you may have got some of that green stuff. I know it has a very strong basil flavor, but there's also some pepper, I think, in there as well. And I think you actually may have gotten a piece of the pepper. We'll try some of the bread as well. On a good note, I didn't get any of the flame burning sensation. But yeah, you're right. It's just regular bread with some sort of a basil oil. It's just okay. It's nothing spectacular. It's not bad, but it's just not anything to celebrate. We'll try the mozzarella ball. Oh, well, that was different. So I squeezed the mozzarella ball, and a juice came flying out of it. Not exactly sure what that juice is, but try it. It's a little spicy. I don't know why. I'm not exactly sure where the heat's coming from. Maybe there's little red flakes of pepper actually in the sauce. I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but it actually had a kick to it.
Are you sure it wasn't the bread?
Fairly confident it wasn't the bread. I think it was that, it was like a red pepper flake. It's not bad though. Once again, nothing special, but it's not bad either. So I just saw you take a mozzarella bite. What?
I got a hot piece.
Did you get one of those red flakes?
My throat's burning again.
Yeah, again. Go for a drink. You got this. Hey, on a good note, the Main Street Fire Station is literally right across the street from the tree, so...
Well, the cheese has a good flavor. The breading was, I don't know, a little greasy.
It was greasy. I think it's because it's marinated in some kind of, like, oil. That's what I think was shooting out of there.
Uh, that might be it. So it's not my favorite cheese ball. But okay. I don't know if I would order it again.
I'm just waiting to see you take that chicken over there to see if your mouth goes on fire again. Because we're two for two.
So this is the chicken parmesan. It is a huge piece of chicken. Came very quick. It looks good. Hopefully it's tastes as good as what it looks.
Connor got the grilled chicken with a side of potatoes. And Melissa got the chicken fettuccine Alfredo.
So the fettuccine is cooked perfectly for me and how I like it. The sauce is thick and has a good flavor to it. And the chicken has a good flavoring as well. So with the first bite, I'm happy. And hopefully the rest of the plate is just as good.
That's good. Just hope you don't run in any hot pieces.
I know, I'm hoping not.
So, while cutting the world's thickest piece of chicken, and it was a very thick piece
of chicken. It's the thickest piece of chicken I've ever seen.
Gigantic piece of chicken. A lot of the cheese fell off, just man down. So now it became just chicken with sauce. So we're gonna give it another go and let you know. It's not bad, but it's kind of like the rest of the meal, where it's good, just not amazing. Like, the breading doesn't have very much flavor to it. It's just like a normal breading.
Was it hard? It seemed a little overcooked.
Certain areas are very crunchy. Like I said, it's not bad. It isn't anything exciting. Even the spaghetti, it's not bad. The sauce is pretty good. I kind of like the sauce. It has a little bit of a kick to it as well. It's a mostly tomato-based sauce, not like a meaty marinara or anything along those lines. Just straight tomato marinara. So it's good. It's just not fantastic. But we'll continue eating, and I'm sure I'm not gonna have any trouble putting this plate of food away and maybe be ready for dessert. Who knows?
So as I got further into my pasta, I realized all the flavor was just in the sauce, and the chicken itself really didn't have any flavoring to it. So by itself, it was kind of bland, but if you got the fettuccine with the sauce and the chicken, it was good, but on its own, again, kind of bland for the chicken.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. Like, obviously, I killed my plate, but the chicken itself was just kind of a side piece, and that's not how it's supposed to be. The chicken should be the main, you know, star of the dish, and yet the spaghetti, which is normally just a complimentary component, ended up being the best part of my dish. All right, so for the children's meals, they're eligible for two sides. The sides aren't the greatest, so we actually went with a cupcake, which is decorated to look like a bowl of spaghetti and meatballs. That's really kind of cool. And then we went with a gelato sundae, which Connor's already, yep, there he goes, eating the sprinkles off of.
So we just finished our meal at Tony's. Well, what do you think of your meal?
So I'm gonna say average. Okay. The fettuccine itself, it was cooked pretty good, so I like that, and I really like the sauce. But as I said in my one video, the chicken itself didn't have a lot of flavoring. At first I thought it did with my first bite, but as I ate more, it was kind of bland. So if you ate the chicken on its own, it really, like I said, didn't have much flavoring to it. But the sauce I thought was delicious. I really liked that. I wasn't too jazzed about the mozzarella balls. I think that for the price, you didn't get very much, and they were kind of oily and greasy. So not my favorite mozzarella stick, or any other shape for that matter. Connor's meal, he got a grilled chicken breast and roasted potatoes, and then two separate sides. We got desserts. So overall, he liked his chicken. I think it was pretty bland, but he doesn't really, you know,
care too much.
Yeah, it doesn't bother him too much whether it has flavor or not. But he ate the chicken, liked that, didn't touch the potatoes, but he normally doesn't anyway. And then he ate his ice cream sundae. He didn't care for the cupcake itself. I think it just had a little bit too much on it. He just likes a plain cupcake with normal icing, but it was a nicely decorated cupcake.
Yeah, I mean, the theme of tonight's meal would be bland. First off, those mozzarella balls, $12 for six balls about the shape of a nickel, size of a nickel. You're basically talking $2 a mozzarella ball for that. Just seems incredibly high priced, and it really wasn't a tasty mozzarella ball. Just,
it's a little hot.
It was some, the, it had some spice to it, yeah, but it wasn't the greatest. The chicken parmesan, you know, the chicken piece was huge. For the amount of money, that was a good value. The chicken was gigantic. However, it had no taste to it whatsoever. The sauce was good, I agree. The sauce was great. As far as Connor's desserts, I actually ate the cupcake, and while it was, like, it looked amazing because it had like a bowl of spaghetti, the sauce that they had on it, it was like a jelly. It didn't work. Did not work with the buttercream and the chocolate cake portion of the cupcake. It just, it fell flat. It wasn't a good combination. So yeah, it looked great. Didn't taste great. However, what I will say about Tony's is there's not too many table service restaurants here in the Magic Kingdom. There's a lot of quick service, but there's not many table service. So to get a table service meal for about the price of what they're at, Tony's compared to like Beast Castle, Cinderella's Royal Table, some of the others, it is much lower. So just keep that in mind. It is a good option if you're in the Magic Kingdom. To go there, you know, the park hopping is coming back. So if you're in another park and you want to come over and eat, go for it. It's a good location. You can't beat that. But anyway, we hope that you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. We'd really appreciate that. And as always, be on the lookout for new content and join us next time when we'll show you why we are loving this world. Bye, everyone.